Let's do this.
Yo, this is Nappy Boy Radio.
The Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Live with your boy, Tpain.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. I am your homeboy, Tpain, a.k.a. your girlfriend's boyfriend.
And I am Vanessa Fraction, a.k.a. Action Fraction, the main attraction, your partner's distraction.
And I am Pip, a.k.a. Mr. Fresh Prince, Mr.
God damn!
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a great motherfucking show for you tonight. Guess why I keep saying that, Vanessa?
Because it's true.
That's motherfucking right, baby! Oh, I love this motherfucking. Don't place lie. Already. This is so good. It's good. I know what the fuck I'm talking about. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the one and only Jacob Latimore.
Yeah.
You had it. I bet that sounded crazy in your head. Yo, listen. I'm about to rap. Check it. Yo. Yeah, your own beat going.
Shut it down.
I'm not sure what to do.
I don't know what to do.
Usually we have like we're forced to go. Shit, what do we do?
Because he's like, I am not for the flow.
Just stop rapping.
Okay.
Yeah, no rapping. Right.
We'll keep it going this time.
That was a practice hit.
Yeah. All right, so.
He's aggressive.
Take a Latimore.
Yes, sir.
What the fuck is going on, brother? Give me some more love. Hey. How the fuck have you been, brother?
I've been good, man. Finally back home. Been working hard on film this year, bro. It's just feels good to be back home in Atlanta, bro. Nice.
Wait, chilling. You keep saying back home in Atlanta.
Yeah.
Oh, you're not from Chicago?
No, I'm not.
You sure?
I'm from Milwaukee.
You're gonna start this early.
Okay. All right. We're gonna.
Yeah,
right. From
the Kansas. Oh, we got a lot to talk about.
Mm. Okay,
we got a lot to talk
so
about.
So I'm confused already.
Why?
I just saw your characters are so good, and I don't know where you're from, and that's fire. First of all, congratulations on doing that.
Hey, that's what it's about, right there.
It is. Your characters are so well played. God damn, I really thought you was from out there.
Nah, well, I mean, Milwaukee, an hour out, but it's close to the Chi.
Yeah,
but it's a difference. Don't tell us what the major is. It's a difference.
These two are Chicago.
I don't know what the major is exactly.
Yeah. I do understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
Is it Chicagoan? Chicagoan?
Like I would say that just
yeah, we are Chicagoans.
Chicagoans.
Well, we were.
Yeah.
What is the major difference?
To me, though, just the slang, the talk.
So it is.
That's important because I was gonna go straight to that.
Yeah.
Like how they pick you to
is it slight? Is it?
Oh, you gotta have it.
I mean, is it like a slight? But it's a slight difference, or is it like
Milwaukee?
Milwaukee got his own like thing. It's definitely different. It's just okay. I don't want to try.
Is it like a New York, New Jersey kind of thing?
Because the
Florida niggas, that's the same place.
Mm. But New York's not New Jersey though.
Oh yeah, well, I'm sure. You don't fucking know that. Yeah. Like that's.
But yeah, Milwaukee, maybe. I don't know. It's just Chicago. Chicago got
Milwaukee
their own slang.
Milwaukee definitely got a different type
Chicago,
of like,
excuse me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Milwaukee, like, kind of like that. When you hear, like, a T Grizzly, like, record, like, the way they talk in that record, like, it's like that Midwest sound.
Ain't
like,
it a blessing?
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just.
It's very Eric Benet-ish.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm.
Eric Benet is from Milwaukee.
I don't think I've ever heard
Even though T Grizzly from
Benet
Detroit,
talk?
Though.
It's very yeah. Eric
I've never heard Eric Benet talk in my life. Have you heard Eric Benet talk?
Eric Benet does talk.
Like just normal? When he's not singing at all?
No, he definitely talk.
I've never heard that.
I think I seen one of his.
He talk, he sound real Midwestish, like you said. Yeah, it's real.
I think I watched some old YouTube videos of him talking one time.
You got to think, when people, like, even when British people sing R&B, like, they sound like they're from.
They
like,
sound great.
Like, they sound like they're from over here, though.
No, they love it, though.
And so I can't tell how my accent is with their singing.
Yeah,
because I just don't know. I don't know.
Because even the actors, the same way you hear them, they sound like.
Well, you know what the thing is too. I was like, I worked with a couple British actors. Their black classics are like the Paid in Fulls or like the
what?
That's their classics to them. You know what I'm saying?
You sure?
Because when we experienced their films, like probably the closest thing we seen to something gritty was like Top Boy. Everything else was so like Sherlock Holmes or like it was just something more like classy, but it's like
right.
it's definitely something more like gritty about London.
I get it. Yeah, I mean, the stuff I watch from over there is like Edgar Wright films and shit.
That's
like
why
that.
They can come over here and do the LA accent so dope, because they study it. You know what I mean? They love it.
That is crazy.
Yeah, like the Paid in Fools, like that monologue in the car, like they love that stuff. You know what
are
I'm saying?
Are they, damn, I said they. That's racist! I don't know. But a lot of British black actors are really getting crazy American roles.
Yeah, and they good.
It's a beautiful thing. That's because
it's not bad.
They're great.
They're fucking killing themselves.
Yeah.
That's like, you can't find nobody here, and we gotta go over there and get them.
Yeah. Then you got got niggas like Idris Elba, just like, I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, I don't. I already did
this
shit.
Going in.
Yeah, that's my going for the next set.
They are killing it.
I'm gonna fuck all y'all bitches over here. No, I mean, I don't think there's like a, because there was something for a while that was like, British black actors are a threat to American black. I don't think that's crazy.
I don't feel that way.
That's nuts. That's just
and
like,
I'm a black actor. Black American actor.
Right. But it's like, bro, just be good, my nigga. Yeah. Like,
that's what they said. They just wanna book the person that's good.
Better at the part, my nigga. Like, just go. If everybody going for the audition in the same kind of way. Everybody got the same shit. If a British actor does a LA accent better than a nigga from LA, then maybe you didn't deserve the
yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it's not just about the accent. Yeah,
it
ain't just about the accent. You know what I mean? Like, sometimes you gotta know how to perform on screen. You know what I mean?
That's what I mean. If things go with it, if you got the look, if you got the image that they had in their head already, then you didn't lose.
I think what's so dope about now though is like, we got shows like The Shy, we got shows like Power, shows like that's it, BMF, and they're not straying too far from our neighborhood. Mm-hmm, so when these kids come on set, they're being themselves. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for real. Absolutely.
So we able to make them superstars. You know what I mean? Rather than take them out of their element where they gotta go to school to. Learn how to play, you know, this particular role. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it ain't like playing like Jamie Foxx tapped into like Ray Charles. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like you literally just like, what up, nigga?
Yeah, you gotta be.
I'm over here chilling.
All you gotta do,
girl, you know what I mean?
Like, all you gotta do is be a nigga from somewhere.
The authenticity.
Exactly.
Be an authentic nigga.
Exactly.
I just can't.
You gotta tap in.
Yeah. Right. But I feel like, is there. How do I say this without sounding like a dick? Mm. I don't think there's any kind of way.
I think there's no way.
Is there not enough
of
right.
roles? I feel like we have so many movies happening at the same
time. Oh, yeah.
I feel like
series is the way. Right
That's
now.
What I'm saying. Not even movies. We got series. We got straight to streaming joints. Mm-hmm. We got, you know what I'm saying? I think we have enough.
Have y'all seen Harder They Fall?
It's not enough because
I want to see it by myself.
I seen it in theaters.
I want to see it without motherfuckers telling me to watch it. I just want to be. Yeah. I want to, because there's this split. And within black people, that's like, you should watch it, or that shit was boring, or it is like, oh, that
you
shit was action packed.
I
want
to
watch it without anything. Yeah. I want to watch it. Hey. I want to watch it how I buy iPhones. When everybody stop doing it, that's when I'm going to go do it.
For sure.
But the movie's hard though.
But for everybody else, I got a lot of friends in that movie. Shout out to Dion Cole. Mm-hmm. Watch The Harder They Fall.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Dion,
R.J. Seiler, Jonathan Majors, Woody, everybody.
Everybody that's in it, I'm really fucking excited. To see them,
yo,
flirt.
I understand what you're saying.
Everybody rocks.
I haven't seen it either yet.
Because I got people in my ear like, oh, you shouldn't need it. Why do you hate this so much? But at the same time, it's like the people that's telling me not to go see Harder They Fall, the people that saw
the first
Madea play and was like, this is the best cinematic event I've ever seen in my life. Only like, my nigga, come on. Like, I get it. Like, don't, right. like, you can't. Like, oh, don't get me
I just haven't had.
I don't be I just like, if I know your taste, if you want a motherfucker that can't taste everything, then I'm not gonna ask you what to eat. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's just
I like how you did that.
Right? Yep. It's just not. I don't know. I'm more open to things than a lot of motherfuckers is in my circles and my camps and motherfuckers. don't get certain kind of comedies, motherfuckers don't get certain kind of dramas and shit like that. Yeah. And then they try to recommend movies for me, and I'm like, you,
Now, once you explain it like that, that makes perfect
sense. Yeah, I'm not trying to follow your code of what black people should like.
Yeah.
Like if I tell you I haven't seen the entire Color Purple, and everybody's like, whoa!
Hold on, may I ask?
Right. But why haven't
have you seen?
I've seen the important parts.
So you never really sat and watched
it's
it all
only
the
one
time.
Part.
No,
right?
That's okay. I haven't seen some things. It's not a series.
You know what? You know what?
I've seen
all the parts of Color Purple that I want to sample to make a beat out of.
No, I actually took a day. I took a day just to watch all the black classics. All of them. Love and Basketball.
I never seen Love and Basketball.
I've never seen Love and Basketball.
I had to take that day because as a young black actor, you really got to tap back into them those movies.
That's a real thing.
You didn't call me to task.
You actually have to. That's another thing. I'm not joking about that. I'm not just going to watch. I got to tap in. I'm not going to watch sports movies.
I'm
it's black
tap
wood.
Movies,
but
it's
got to watch those.
I've seen The Wood.
I've seen The Wood. Yeah. I mean, there are certain movies.
Oh, you got to watch Brown Sugar.
There are certain movies that you get like called not black enough for if you
boxing movies.
I've only seen
just boxing movies just out of nowhere.
I'm just saying
just nothing.
Just
you. All the Rockies.
Love, I've only seen Love Jones one time.
I said boxing.
What you supposed
basketball.
To watch it more than what?
They say you
basketball.
Are. They say you're supposed
no, watched,
to love it
I watched,
like that.
I watched
I've only
it like
seen
like
it one
times.
Time. But I listened to the soundtrack so many times.
How many times did you watch Friday?
Very healthy amount.
I just want to say. We don't get to just watch Friday. Nobody actually, I mean, if everybody has seen Friday more than once, yeah. Nobody just puts Friday on.
No,
you just walk into a place where everybody's already watching
it. It's happening.
It's not, it's
yeah.
never
it's,
a fuck.
Yeah.
No, I definitely
right,
have
it's
watched,
on.
Yeah. Friday, a healthy amount of time.
You've never
Friday.
Seen anybody actually start playing Friday, though. You have always just walked into somewhere
I haven't ever really pushed
playing.
My finger
except
on
except
it.
My girl. She, like, turned Friday on right now.
Okay,
I feel like
well, that's just that's okay. just a toxic yeah. relationship.
Shout, shout out to his girl. I like how you plugged
her
in.
You got to talk to her. You got to talk to her about the choices
job.
That happened in the
nah,
household.
she know every line, line for line.
I mean, it's a really good movie to know.
It's a fire.
It's a really good movie.
The first one classic.
That's the one I'm talking about. I'm not talking about
yeah. But honestly, all of them were like solid though.
I was about to ask you, what do you think about the commercialization as it went on? Mm-hmm. Was that
with the Friday after next?
The Friday saga.
Yeah.
The commercialization of it as it went on, I don't think was a bad thing. I think that was Ice Cube really elevating this fucking company.
No, it was great because it was like we seen just the film elevate. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm,
like
mm-hmm.
You could tell they weren't working with that much, but sometimes when you're not working with that much, it's like
right.
You get even more creative. You
absolutely.
Know what I'm saying? The shots,
yeah.
How they introduce Chris Tucker, like it's like
mm-hmm,
they
mm-hmm.
zoom, they pan in on him. It's like it was fire.
I mean, since you was a young boy.
Since you
yeah.
was a,
I had to sing that. Yeah.
But
yeah,
I don't know.
Me too.
Anymore.
I had to sing that shit in school. But
I had to sing
what was that?
Man, because the last time you were in my house,
yep.
You were 16?
Yeah, bro. Like 15, 15 to 16. Somewhere.
And I was a young boy.
But
visions.
Since then, though, I've admired your views on pretty much everything that you've openly talked about. So it's been a journey seeing you grow up and like being on set with you and,
yeah.
You know, doing a song with you and filming a video with you and getting to meet your peoples and stuff like that and seeing your background, really where you came from. You really appreciate the shit that needs to be appreciated. And that's something that is rarely celebrated, but I will tell you this: we will celebrate it to here on the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast.
Yeah,
hey.
Bro.
That's good shit. So,
yeah.
In light of that, I'm gonna ask you the most important question we ask on the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast.
Uh oh. Question time.
How is your mental health these days?
There you go. Look over here.
This nigga laughs.
Yeah.
I thought we weren't gonna talk about this. I thought we said we weren't gonna talk about this.
Oh no, we talk about it every time. This is the most important question. We need to check on our people. We need to be informed on how our people are being treated and how our people feel these days. But how is your mental health these days?
Hey man, I'm just going through it right now. I'm just really depressed. And
I know you're not.
No, I'm
not. I know you're not. You don't.
No, I'm not. Thankfully, you know what I mean. I'm, yeah. But it's every day we all under construction, you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So it's like every day is a new day to see something positive. I think for me, I just try to just surround myself around people I love. I think that's ultimately what we want in the end after we get the money to
fame,
all that other stuff. We just want to be around some good energy and good love.
Yeah. I always tell people, man, you know, my friends and my close family and stuff like that, and you know, they always try to bring me back to a grounded place, and I'm like, man, can you imagine having thousands of people that would like literally break into a place to come see you?
Yeah.
And then the people that you actually want to be around don't want to be around.
Right. Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? The people that you love, the people that you done treated like shit because you know that there's thousands of people over here and you're not worried about the six people over here. Just to have that trade-off is like, man, that's devastating. And then when you realize that these people will drop you at a heartbeat and these people going to love you regardless, and then you try to go back.
Yeah.
That's the fucking heartbreak.
That's that lesson right there. Yeah.
That's the heartbreak right there.
That's that lesson. Because sometimes you can burn them bridges forever.
Oh my God! You know what I mean? There's no coming back from pure fire.
Yeah.
No, so
he dead.
Yeah. So it's good to know that you kept that ground, and you know, because you started out so young.
Mm-hmm. I did.
You know, a lot of people get to see this lifestyle, but they get to it real late. Mm-hmm. And they already stuck in their ways because they're an adult.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then they don't get to come back from that shit, and they lose friends forever. They lose family forever. People don't talk to them until they end up in the hospital on their deathbed. Yeah. And that's when they get to say, I'm sorry. Or they don't make it. And then, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, whew. That got depressing real
quick. Yeah, it did. I was all in my feelings.
We went deep.
I was looking up into the distance.
I'll tell you what, it lightened up the mood a little bit. Drinks from Pan Pan. Let's go. I don't know if you know, my wife is a certified mixologist. She makes every single guest their own drink.
Mixology.
Oh my God, she's gonna bring it around. This is my wife, Pan Pan. She makes everybody a drink. She made yours special.
Incredible.
I got it. The glasses are special. This is special. Oh my God, this is gonna be hard to deal with. Yeah.
Oh my God.
she made this one special, and how she didn't spill. This is beyond me because these bitches do not stay up. I think they're supposed to look like they're gonna.
Okay.
Cool. They look like they're gonna spill over.
Oh.
I thought that was all on your lap right there.
Look.
My shit twirling.
Good stuff. As you can see, there's a globe etched in two.
Oh, shit.
You know,
it's a vibe, though.
Etched in two.
It's a world
because it's called.
Heartbreak heard around the world.
Come on, somebody. That's what I thought. Ladies and gentlemen, this is.
I forgot about.
Yeah.
Just trying to survive and I was thinking about. Hey,
this is the heartbreak heard around the world.
2 ounces tequila, 1/2 ounce kiwi puree, 1/2 ounce strawberry puree, 1/2 ounce cream of coconut, 2 ounces of lime juice, 2 ounces of pineapple juice, 1 strawberry coconut mini popsicle, or all of the purees, cream of coconut, juices, and tequila into a shaker with ice. Strain into a cup and place miniature popsicle into drink. And there you have the heartbreak heard around the world.
Let's go.
I would love to drink this anywhere in the world. This makes me feel like we're on vacation.
You're not supposed to like it this much.
It's really good. That's what I said. I would drink this anywhere in the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, sip. Delicious. Drink. We will be right the fuck back. Jacob, hit the button.
Shut it down.
We will be right back. Nappy Boy Radio Podcast.
Keep saying it with
delicious.
What's good, guys? It's your homeboy, Tpain, coming at you about something pretty cool. Thanks for watching the show, too, by the way. If you find yourself working out or living an active lifestyle or just want some more energy like myself, I got to tell you, man, you got to give concrete a try. Seriously, it's like one of the best things out there. But wait, Tpain, what do you mean? Here's what I mean. Maybe you don't know the benefits of creatine, but science has long been up on the game. Creatine basically helps fuel every cell in the body, from your immune system to fight diseases, to your muscles, all the way up to your mind. So, you know, it's one of those things that kind of does everything. Me personally, I've tried other supplements. This is the only one that I find is actually worth the money. The results are super direct, and the taste, which is super important to me, is actually pretty good. So that's, you know, you got it's mostly the taste. That's really what makes it the most worth it. But the container was way smaller than I was expecting. The whole thing fits in my hand outside of the box. Once I get it out of the box, it fits in my hand. You got to see it. I will take it out of the box. It's just plastic. It's a lot going on. But that tells you how small the doses are. And I think you're going to be good to go. Concrete is also the only microdose creatine out there. So basically, it means smaller portions to drink. Don't have to drink a whole 8 days worth of... Don't worry about me. If you've been looking for a new supplement to help out your workouts and active lifestyle, hook yourself up with Concrete. It'll give you the strength and endurance benefits of creatine without any of the negative side effects like bloating and cramping. So what do you think? If you want to give Concrete a try, here's a little bonus for you right here, right? Check this out. All you got to do is enter to win a free Planet Fitness gym membership plus Concrete for a whole year plus a $500 Visa gift card. Now take better control of your health, body, mind, all that. Get Concrete into your life today. Register now at concrete.com/podcast. That's Concrete, concrete.com/podcast. Available now at Walmart, walmart.com. Concrete is truly changing the fitness and health game. Go to concrete.com/podcast. Feel me? Good stuff. Have fun with the rest of the show. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Jacob Latimore, this bitch killing it. Yeah. Yeah. Definitely not a podcast going on here. Jacob?
Yeah.
Are you ready for?
Am I ready for what?
Your top five.
Yeah, the top five, baby.
My what?
Top five.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no. Different subject for everybody.
Okay.
It's not something you're thinking. Okay. I guarantee it. Ooh. It's not something you're thinking about. Not something you think I'm going to ask you. Okay. Your top five is your very own. Okay. And you're going to piss people off. Mm. This is
what happens.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is a part of it. And I know you pay attention to the industry a lot.
Mm-hmm.
You're really in tune with what's going on in the world.
All right.
And your industry. Right. I'm trying to kind of get you ready for it, but you're not going to be.
I'm not ready.
This is your top five. Jacob Latimore, what are your top five celebrity relationships?
I wasn't ready for that.
Top five.
Hey. Ooh, I got to think about that. I got something in my mind, though. I got something in my mind.
Okay. Number one.
That's usually what you start with.
Yeah. I'm gonna say me and Soraya. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
We up there.
Look, you just got some points, you know.
We up there.
Solid handy J when you get to the crib.
Solid.
God damn.
She gonna watch this shit like this nigga crazy.
That's usually what everybody says. But okay, all right. Number two.
Probably Usher and Chili.
Ooh. Okay.
Wow.
Usher and Chili.
Nice. Okay. You got to.
Do they got to be current?
I understand.
They got to be current?
No.
Oh, okay.
You ain't got to explain your joint, but you got to tell us what was going on in that one. That was like, yeah.
Usher and Chili?
Yeah.
I mean, I think, like, they just, I don't know. They just look perfect. I mean, I'm not sure.
Was it because they're both dark skin? Is that what it is? Are you colorist? Is that
what's
happening?
Oh, my God.
Is that what's happening? God!
The way he had it in the videos, like it was just a vibe. Like they was rock stars.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I like it.
They was rock stars.
That is pretty cool. It truly is over the top pretty.
Yeah.
Let me see.
Stupid fine.
Stupid.
Yeah. I'm gonna say, you know, number three. I have to say Angelina Jolie and Brad.
Ah. Okay. He accepted all them
children. That's actually pretty good.
I'll take that.
Yeah, and added more to it.
A lot of kids.
They had a lot of children. And they seem
happy.
Why do you think they didn't want to?
They are from Angelina?
She had some adopted ones before he came along. And then
they just kept adopting, right?
And had them. Then she had.
They had it. Okay, so she was pregnant at some point.
Oh, yeah.
How many did she have out of her?
Now I got to Google
super
it.
Crazy body.
I think was it three? Then they have. I don't know. I gotta look it up now.
But her presence itself is just like, whoa. Like it's like
she does have a very.
Her eye contact.
Was that the wind that just went by? It's that eye contact, bro.
It's the shit she do. Ooh, got yeah. crazy eyes, big old mouth. Big crazy.
She actually gave a super dope speech during the kids. I think it was like I was at the Kids Choice Awards or something.
You can't transition from me saying she got a big mouth.
What she said today? I forgot. She just said something like super like graceful, and she was like just. Hella like happy.
It moved.
She was glowing. That shit was. Oh. She was a queen.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Angelina Jolie.
You know this is fucked up. You didn't say anything about your relationship like this, but I'm just gonna let you.
No, I'm just saying.
I'm just slaying.
I said we number one.
No, you did.
We didn't go into that.
Number one.
Oh no, this is in no particular order, by the way. He got a fucked up. Just wanted you to elaborate. If, do you want to go back and elaborate on yours? So you
I always elaborate on mine.
Okay. Ooh, all right. That's impressive.
I'm good at home.
Okay.
All right.
Damn. All right.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. What's number four?
Number four. Let's see.
All these people we can find pictures of.
You will. Yeah, I.
Boom.
Yeah.
Go.
Here we go.
Number four.
Take your time. We're gonna cut all this out. We close.
We gotta go Will and Jada with it, man.
They take it to the table. You gotta love that. They do take it to the table. They honest. You feel me?
No,
that was 719.
He got one more.
Did you have one more?
You got one more.
This is the one you're gonna piss everybody off because.
Okay, maybe my order is a little messed up, but
no, there's no order. There's no order. It's just a five.
Jay-Z, Beyonce.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's because they billionaire.
I thought you were gonna say Viola Davis and her husband.
I thought you were gonna say
Angela Bassett and Courtney B. Vance.
Yeah, it's like, but
I like them.
No, they're fire.
Damn.
But they don't like market themselves as like celebrity
couples.
That's why I like them.
You know what I'm saying? But that's why I like them.
I didn't.
But it wasn't my top five. It was your top five.
You know what I'm saying?
This is a preview of how the entire internet is going to react.
Right, right.
So,
how could you not say?
No, right. I was only fucking with you. No. But honestly, but no, it's your top five.
Okay,
and
so
Jay-Z, Beyonce is a dope.
I gotta ask.
Like my generation.
Yeah,
you know
it is.
I gotta ask because you know everybody has one. Do you have a story that you spilled something on one of the?
On
one of the Carters.
What?
Everybody spilled something on one of the Carters. You ain't made it in Hollywood.
Oh, spilled something.
If you ain't spilled something, not a story, physically spilled a drink on one of the Carters.
No, I never had.
Yeah. Well, we got a story.
Yeah,
we ain't got no stories. We ain't got no
stories. Oh, okay.
You sure?
I was just saying.
We ain't got no stories.
No, that wasn't me.
No,
ain't nobody going to be doing that.
If you do have one,
could you know? I may just do my own radio table.
Okay, all right. God damn it. Well, guess what? That was a top five.
Yeah.
We will.
I like that.
Go ahead.
We shutting it down?
Go ahead.
Shut it down. We'll be right back. We don't know what the fuck is going on.
Is that Alexa?
Ho, 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 gentlemen. The holidays have come early this year as Manscaped has the gift that keeps on trimming. Santa's beard isn't super appealing when it's coming out of your trousers. And that's why Manscaped, the leaders in below-the-waist grooming, have you covered this holiday season. Now available in your country, join the 4 million men worldwide who trust Manscaped to keep their trees trimmed and ornaments polished. Go to manscaped.com/tpain for 20% off and free shipping. Jingle balls to the walls, fellas. Listen up. It's time to kill two birds with one trimmer and get yourself and your lady a gift. I'm talking about Manscaped Performance Package 4.0. Inside the Performance Package 4.0, you'll find the Lawnmower 4.0. This electric trimmer has proprietary advanced skin-safe technology to reduce cuts on your nuts. It's also waterproof, so you can use it in the shower. It's like a gift to your partner with less mess. The Manscaped Performance Package 4.0 also includes the Crop Preserver and Crop Reviver, an anti-chafing ball deodorant, moisturizer, and toner. This hygiene bundle would also come with a pair of Manscaped anti-chafing boxers. That's the perfect wrapping for your presents. The Manscaped Performance Package comes with all the tools to clean up his delicate places. Included in this new package is the Weed Whacker ear and nose hair trimmer, which is waterproof as well, and also uses a 9,000 RPM motor-powered 360 rotary dual blade system. Nobody, not even Santa, wants hairs under their chimney. Tis the season to load up on Manscaped products, so go ahead and get yourself, your dad, your brother, and your friends the best gift of all time. The Manscaped Performance Package 4.0. Get 20% off plus free shipping when you go to manscaped.com/tpain. Get 20% off and free shipping when you go to manscaped.com/tpain. Clean up your nuts and make Santa proud this year.
On today's episode of How Fucked Up Is Fucked Up. That's fucked up.
Jacob!
Yes, sir.
What's fucked up?
What's fucked up? It's a lot of shit fucked up, man.
I know. You want to know what I think is fucked up?
What's fucked up?
People that put milk in bowls before cereal.
I just did that yesterday.
What? You are.
I just did it yesterday for the first time. And I was like,
you gotta fucking leave. You gotta fucking leave.
Yo, I was like, I was like, it's about to be the new way.
What the? Oh, really?
Hell no.
I thought that was going a whole different way.
I did too. I don't like too much milk.
Yeah.
So I just.
What the fuck is too much milk?
It's too much milk in the cereal. Like, I don't.
Don't put more cereal. No, I don't understand.
That's what I'm saying. I was able to, like.
I don't understand how you don't fix the problem.
I was able to. It was just a different perspective.
Bro, this shit got you. This shit you doing right now got you going crazy, bro.
I did it.
Tell us about this motherfucker. This crazy ass fucking diet you got going on right now.
It's not a crazy diet, bro. It's
not the way of fat people. I will tell you that. it's not safe,
man.
For
you
fat
know,
people.
I just be acting, man. I got my shirt off a lot. I try to just stay in shape. That's all.
Yeah.
And then when it's time to tap in, you know, we was just lit the other day. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah. No, I know. And now
it's time. Like, I'm about to start back filming in like 2 months. So it's that time.
You gotta get ready. It's 2 months, like the optimal time to like start.
I think that's where I'm at with my. You know what I'm saying? That's how
I changed my fucked up. You know what I think is fucked up?
What? I definitely want to hear this.
Motherfuckers that start working out 2 months before they got to do anything, and then they call me 3 days in advance and be like, "Hey, can you come on this shit too?"
Right.
I hate that shit. Motherfuckers always call me at the last minute. I just filmed the whole TV show for 30 days, and they call me 3 days. Yeah. Before we had to film.
Yeah, man.
And he was like, come on in. I was like, I've been eating whole pizzas by myself this whole month.
Nah,
I
can't. In the fun days. And I film in Chicago, so pizza is just like everywhere.
Oh, so good.
You know what I'm saying? So like the temptation be crazy. Like
that makes sense. But what's actually fucked up for you? What do you think is fucked up? And it can be any small thing. It's
fucked
be,
up. I don't know.
So people that don't put their fucking carts back when you got a whole cart thing. Just go put the cart in the cart in the cart thing.
Right next to the cart thing.
Yes. Just put it in there.
Target is a landmine with that shit. You don't know where to park it. You don't know where to park it because you can get ran into from any side with a goddamn cart. And people, it takes a little bit of wind.
Right, and they get on top of that motherfucking
yeah.
Like a scooter and shit.
Boom. I mean, I do that, so.
I do that, too, though. Not in the parking lot, though.
No, like, I do it in the parking
in
lot.
In the store.
I do, too.
All right, yeah.
One parking lot had, like, a hill, and I was like, I was going to town. I was like.
Absolutely. I might be the one fucking up all the wheels on the Target joint by our house.
He'd be like.
This is my cart.
That motherfucker be Harlem shaking. And you got to hold it because it keeps going to the right.
Swag, my boy.
You like, damn.
But I know you got something that you think is fucked up. For real.
What's fucked up?
What's fucked up? I know it's something one of your homeboys do that you don't really fuck with.
You stupid as fuck.
Because that's mostly what it is. It's usually one of our homeboys. For me, it's you.
What does he do? What do you do?
Really?
Yeah.
For me, he keeps getting his goddamn facial hair cut like this, and he knows it grows more than this.
It's very villainous.
He keep doing this. It's like a villain.
Like,
does it come out wide like this?
No, it don't come out.
It do come out everywhere, but it stopped getting it cut like a goddamn Bond villain.
He does.
I'm not gonna talk about you in front of your girl.
Dun 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 dun. Crazy. It's like that happens every time you come in the room.
Jacob, what's fucked up?
What's fucked up, man? People still hungry on the streets. You know
come
what I'm
on
saying?
Now.
That's what's fucked up.
Come on now.
That's a good one.
That's what's fucked up.
That was good. That was real.
They can fix that, right?
It's a lot of money out here.
Can they?
Yes, they can.
I think they can.
They can.
Yes, they can.
They don't want to. Are they gonna?
Yes, they can.
You think
are they gonna?
Yes, they can.
What do you think it's gonna take?
How much money they give out? this last year.
Oh, just all the time?
Ooh.
Yeah.
I mean, we got to weigh in what all the lotteries and shit was.
That's what I'm saying.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they got enough for that.
That's crazy.
Yeah, they got enough to just, they boying the money.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what they doing.
They got enough to give out.
People still hungry, bro.
Yeah, people are still hungry, and they give out lottery tickets and shit, and they make millions off the shit, and if somebody wins it, they give away millions.
They give away millions.
It's control.
And then the person that get the million got to hide from their fucking family.
Forever.
Forever and ever.
Yeah, yeah, it's over.
The fact that there's still hungry people in the world
is crazy.
Very fucked up. Bernie Sanders, get on it, man. What are you doing? No, he's really trying. Thank you, Bernie. And Elon Musk.
Just... I didn't mean to get all in the politics.
No, this was the part of it. This is it.
this is it.
But no, everybody that can help, please help. That's just, God damn.
Thanksgiving coming up. I'll just be thinking about it. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. Now you done piled on Thanksgiving.
Shit!
Now we got to give away turkeys.
The one time where people ain't supposed to be hungry.
Turkeys are double the price these years. We're going to have to eat turkey burgers.
Yeah.
For Thanksgiving this
year.
But
why the price go up?
Because of the supply chain and stuff. I don't know. Just everything's going up.
Everybody's got anything you, any question you got, people just going to say, oh, you know the pandemic just happened.
No, well, stuff.
Stuff. Yeah, yeah, no, stuff. You know the stuff just happened. Yeah.
You know, the truckers. Yeah. They can't, you know.
Don't nobody want to go to work no more.
Yeah. Pandemic.
Yeah, right. Truck we ain't got nobody to pluck the feathers from the turkey.
Nah, yeah.
That's what it is. Job shortage.
Job shortage.
No, there's jobs. Stuff. I mean, employee shortage.
Employee shortage.
Yep.
Because
folk got other things to do.
Y'all ain't paying enough.
Listen, oh, obviously they
Everybody got internet jobs.
Not paying enough.
Which is... Those are paying a lot. All right, anyways.
Okay, there we have it.
Hunger.
Shout out to all the business owners out there. You know what I'm saying? Starting their business from the ground up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
No
it's
joke.
Tough out here. From it's hard.
It is tough out here, cuz.
It's hard.
It's hard out here. It's hard out here.
It says hard.
It's hard, cuz. But yeah, hungry people. Fucked up.
What else fucked up?
This commercial break?
Yeah.
Shut it down. We'll be right back, baby.
50 on the dash. Ooh. Sitting still on an ass. Ooh. I need to remedy. This shit is sending me times infinity. Shit. Goddamn. Don't need that minute. So y'all on the energy. This shit is hitting me. Shit. Oh, man. Y'all ain't feeling it. Y'all intensity. Keep it 250 feet. Y'all been pissing me. Y'all...
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, indeed. Yeah. I really appreciate that. Jacob.
Yes, sir.
What is the Nappy Boy Radio Song of the Week?
I get to choose?
Yes, you do.
Yeah, any song. Ooh, literally any song.
What you going to do?
We got to go clap. We got to play ours.
We got to play ours.
We got to go back.
Nice. Okay.
We got to play Heartbreak Heard Around the World, man.
Well, there it is. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jacob Latimore featuring Tpain, Heartbreak Heard Around the World. And for some reason, I've watched like 10 times. That was a good amount of what the fuck was happening there.
Yeah.
Okay.
That was crazy.
That shit was good, man.
What a time to be alive.
Yeah.
God damn. Yeah, well, I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, soak that in.
Yeah.
Whatever the fuck that was. We'll be right back. Hey.
Shut it down.
Shut it down.
Radio Podcast. Love y'all.
Hello.
You know I'ma be rooting you on like go, babe. Go, go, go.
Of the Latimore.
It's time for your
button game.
Let's get it.
Please don't
What's
be
the
a
button
fucking
game?
Simp, man.
Jacob Latimore.
Don't be a simp on this, please.
Don't be a simp. What you mean?
Jacob Latimore.
What we about to do?
You'll see.
Just wait.
You'll see.
Okay.
Jacob Latimore.
It's about gone.
A man walks into your house, invited, not uninvited. You let a man into your house because it's very intriguing. Now, let me tell you why you let this man in your house. Because he has a box.
Get that.
The box.
What the hell is
in
his box, man?
Somebody
about to jump out of
it. Nothing's going to jump out of
you.
I'm telling you.
Jacob,
you got dogs and shit.
Jacob, the dogs are locked away safely.
No, I said
the dolls. Oh, the doll is also
the doll is there, but the dolls are
Jacob.
Away.
You let a man into your house. You know why you let a man into your house? Because it's intriguing. Because the man has a box in his hand. And he says, Jacob, in this box, I have a button. Now, if you decide to hit this button, you can get anything that you want.
Anything.
Tangible in the world. Now, when we say tangible, we mean something you can see, taste, acquire,
touch,
feel. All
mm.
that shit. Something that's real. It's not.
The suspense is killing.
It's not a magical button. Wait till you hear what the music behind is. Crazy. we gotta do that in post. Anything you can acquire.
Now I'm trying to listen for it. Like
touch, taste, feel, see, experience. Mm-hmm. Something tangible. It's not a magic button.
Can't bring people back to life.
But when you hit that button, you get that thing you want, but
damn,
somebody in the world is gonna fucking die.
Gone.
Damn.
Finito.
It could be somebody you know. It could be somebody you know. It could be me. It could be this nigga. It could be a 25-year-old with perfect health. When you hit that button, boom, heart attack.
Somebody.
No, hold on. Let me finish explaining.
Yeah.
Could be a 25-year-old with perfect health. When you hit that button, boom, heart attack. Could be second Hitler. Could do some good. You never know. It also could be a mother baby.
What?
And I said what I said.
Here's the kicker.
Okay.
Let me say this.
I'm getting nervous.
Here's the thing. Because we're making it more serious.
Yeah, it is serious.
If you don't hit the button, your girl dies.
Oh, you just took it up.
You did that.
Because you just took it up.
No, we don't do the guests anymore.
I got it.
We don't do the guests anymore. It's whoever they love the most.
Thank you.
If you don't hit the button, because anybody going to sacrifice themselves. We've learned that people will be like, because we used to say if you don't hit the button, you die. And everybody's like, oh, I'll just die. Nah, if you don't hit the button, your girl dies. You piece of shit. Now, what is.
Now I'm less nervous.
What is. That's cool. Oh, keep in mind.
There you go.
Can't keep anybody alive. Okay. Can't bring anybody back to life. Mm-hmm. What is that one thing?
What's that thing?
That you would hit that button for.
It is.
Yes, Skurskeezy.
What's that one thing? If you only had one wish.
If you had one wish to hit, when you hit that button,
you
get that thing. But somebody's got to die. But if you don't hit that button, your girl dies.
You're going to do it.
Wait, explain it one more time.
Oh, see,
what is the one thing that you
I need clarity.
What is the one thing you would wish for that you would hit that button and a random person dies? But if you don't hit the button, your girl dies.
Oh, bro, I'm pressing the button.
For
what is it?
What's the one thing that you would hit the button for? Because you're gonna It has to be a material.
Okay.
Tangible.
A thing.
Tangible. See, touch, hear, taste, experience.
Okay.
Not.
Gotcha. Okay.
It's a tangible thing that you have to have.
Okay. Let me see.
Oh, you did, Damon.
Let me see.
Yeah, you better
not. I don't know. Time running, right?
No. Think about it.
As much time as you got.
As much time as you need.
Let me see.
Probably
something I want.
Yeah.
Something you want.
And whatever a random person died.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I ain't gotta know him.
But it could be somebody you know. It's gonna be a random people you know are random also, by the way.
Right.
Yeah. Nothing exclude. But if you don't hit the button, your girl dies.
No. I'm definitely pressing this, but I'm just trying to figure out what I want.
Okay.
Yeah, no. We'd like to know that as well.
We'd definitely like to know.
Fuck, the same time you figuring it out, we're trying to do that too.
I don't know what I want, bro. Let me say.
Oh, you want to kill your girl then?
No.
He said he definitely not doing that.
Definitely not doing that.
He's just trying to think of how big the boat need to be. That's what he trying to
That's so funny you said that, because I was just thinking about
how big do the boat need to be.
We need to explain this a little further. Whatever you get, it happens once.
Oh, yeah.
And that's it.
It's done.
Once and that's
it. It just happens. So if you if you want like $1 million, you just get $1 million and that's it. But somebody died for that. Yeah, so it's if you try to do like a boat to an island that's not occupied by it, we're not doing that. One thing, one time.
I see what
one
thing.
But you could like get an island though, right?
Yeah.
That's one thing, one time. Yeah,
but that's like a
why not just a boat, thing?
Though? What? No, I was just saying.
You could get a boat, like Jeff Bezos.
What's his name?
I'm talking
about Bezos's boat.
You talking about a boat like stocked with food for years?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. That's it. Yes.
There's boats big enough to put like all type of shit on. Like there's
for sure.
Huge yachts.
Yeah, the yachts, the fly one.
Yeah,
that's not sustainable.
I was gonna say, is that
it doesn't matter if it's sustainable. It's what he wants.
Oh,
I mean, hey. It's what he wants.
That's
who
it.
Who gives a fuck if he can put gas in it?
It's a boat.
He says he wants it.
What else do I want?
Oh, well, that's cool with me. I'm just saying. You gonna just shut all that shit
just
down?
Just saying.
Anyway,
if you want something, get a house with that.
I got one.
You gotta say.
Boom. He said he got a house.
Stay in that house.
Flexed on everybody.
Yeah. He said I got a big ass house. Now I got a big ass boat.
I don't want nothing.
I ain't got no boat.
Okay. Don't have a boat.
But you. The point is,
you know how many boats? You know how much money we spent on renting our boats?
Wait, nigga, you for wait.
Mm, I don't.
Bitch, you Hold on, bitch, you back home in Atlanta. You ain't got nowhere to put a boat. Like, what the
You said you want to go to Lake Lanier.
You said you want a boat.
No, no, we can have it in Miami.
Well, first of all, everybody dies in Lake Lanier.
No, we're not going to Lake Lanier. Not for no yacht.
But you're going to drive all the way down there and take the boat.
You
want
to drive?
Fly.
Well, how you going to get the boat down there?
The boat?
Bro, we got people for that. Somebody to take care of the boat.
Okay, give me a second.
You own the boat. All
right, we need to
figure it out. Let's back it up.
Back it up.
This is a difficult question. It's not even that difficult.
Okay, first of all,
y'all making an answer difficult.
We're judging you.
Because there's restrictions.
No, I'm saying we shouldn't.
Where you get the plane from? Just from previous funds and shit?
So I'm like.
I said one thing one time.
One time.
Right. You start adding planes and shit. And it started
He said, "How am I gonna get
that
to the
was
boat?"
Pimp.
Yeah, that's
said,
a valid
that
question. How are you gonna get to the boat?
Bruh.
Do you already have the plane money?
You get yes.
Okay, well you got that.
You can get on the train.
Come on. Well,
that's
come
just
on,
gonna
Jacob.
Take a few days. Whoever you killed is gonna be dead before you get to.
I got a mule pulling my boat down to Miami. Jacob said I got 6 mules.
Yeah, I got work.
They pulling my boat
workers.
Down to Miami. Don't
I find,
you,
hey, but
don't y'all make
find,
no, though. Don't you make
saying?
No, never mind where
this nigga
I
got a boat.
Yeah, that's true.
The boat is waiting on you.
When this motherfucker get the flood, now I got a boat.
You got a boat?
Come on, Pip. Come on,
wait,
Jacob.
Wait, what? How did this turn into Noah's Ark? Yeah.
We want
the
boat.
Nobody said that the world was ending.
Hey, man, we don't know.
No, we do.
It may happen one time and one time only.
60-foot yacht.
I'd be mad if it doing, and we ain't got the fucking boat this nigga wanted. That's what I would be mad about, that we didn't get the boat.
Wait, hold on. When in this scenario did the world start ending?
Did y'all watch The Walking Dead? Remember when they had that yacht?
Yeah,
remember that?
How?
Okay.
Of course we did.
All right. Wait a minute. Now we're just bringing in other.
No.
Okay. Stop.
Okay. So when I
stop.
Question.
Stop. Stop.
Question.
Shut up.
Wait.
Shut up.
Wait.
Wait. Shut up. Stop.
Okay. Wait.
Jacob, go. All
right. So if I get this boat,
yeah.
Who died?
Don't know.
I don't know.
You don't know.
Okay. So if I don't know, then I'll get the boat.
The boat.
Cause like
don't
if
clap
I
for that shit.
No,
clap
because,
for that.
Because if, you get, if I get hey. The boat, if I get something, I don't know who dies. It could be
there
random.
You go.
Somebody get the boat.
But if I don't press it, I
what do you?
I know who's gonna die.
Why do you need this boat?
Because it's fly.
You know what?
We trying to be on the water.
I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm not gonna Jacob.
Boat.
I feel like
we got the boat.
Jacob. I feel like you could just get this boat right now. I don't think you need the button for this.
No, I need the boat.
He said, "But do you need the button?
You don't need the button
yeah.
to get the boat. You could have just got the boat.
You just buy the boat.
The shot check.
Jacob, let's not. First of all, stop acting like
you didn't say that though.
Hey, bro, stop acting like you're not.
You didn't.
Fucking,
you didn't say that though,
bro. Let's,
but you said a house. I said
let's
I got a house.
Let's stop acting like you're not fucking Jerome Musk.
No, but I bet you.
You
not Jerome Musk.
I think we all know you.
I like that name,
bro. Like I think we all know that. Stop trying to act like you're a regular person real quick.
It's levels, bro.
To this.
It's levels.
To this.
My house is not this big.
I like.
Oh, you just ain't went far enough into debt. I think we all figured out.
You stupid.
So, look. Okay, Jake, let's think about this for a second.
Man, a boat is fire.
Man, that nigga, he gonna kill a motherfucker.
He
that
has
boat.
Not changed his mind about this boat, and I don't think.
Bro, all summer I was on boats.
You ain't said a size. You ain't said nothing. Because if the dude
big boat.
Was on some.
Well, I don't know the exact numbers, but I wanted to be a nice size.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
What's a nice size to him? Warren Buffett? Because he just got a little fishing joint.
No. Nah, he said Jeff Bezos' boat.
Yeah, something like that.
The one they was on.
It fit like maybe.
They was flying helicopters 20, off 25 that boat.
People or something.
A boat.
Yeah.
You will straight up murder somebody for a fucking boat.
Give me that boat.
Sure.
Hey, I'll fuck with that.
Give me that motherfucking boat.
I'll fuck with that.
He says, that's what you doing?
Give me what you got.
He said, that's what's for dinner.
Boat, nigga.
A boat.
A yacht.
A boat?
Yeah. A yacht.
I hear what you're saying, man.
Let's say yacht. Let's say yacht.
A yacht.
Yeah, a yacht.
Yachty.
A yacht. Mm-hmm. You killed somebody for the yacht.
Yeah, I killed
them. Yeah. Well, goddamn. That's what I can't do nothing about that.
What's happening?
Jesus, man.
I'm a straight up pirate in that motherfucker.
Yes,
give me that motherfucking yatch, bitch. Give me that shit.
You gotta pay no more. Damn,
y'all come. Y'all want to be on the boat?
Look,
you know they gonna get on the boat.
Just give me a size of a yacht.
You know we. I don't know the size. I wouldn't even know.
Over 100 feet.
I don't even know what that looks
yes,
like.
Yes, he wants over 100-foot yacht to kill somebody.
That's.
I want one like the Titanic.
Too big.
No, it's not.
Is it too big?
No, that's, not no. to kill.
Have you
someone?
Seen Rick Ross's house, nigga? Are you asking if shit is too big to be on the water?
I mean,
at least.
This is no. Look,
that's starting.
Everybody in this house.
I could take a jog through this house and get a good workout in.
Yeah, you could, but you think about taking down your 100-foot yacht.
That's
just
stairs. Yeah, your 100-foot.
Wait, we're not jogging on the yacht though.
We're not jogging on the yacht.
More than that.
Oh, fucking.
That's it. That's it.
50-foot yacht,
that's not,
75.
That's not big enough.
Nah, 100.
75.
I guess 100.
100-foot yacht, you'll kill somebody. Fuck them kids.
Fuck them kids.
There we go.
Gotta go.
Jacob Latimore wants a 100-foot yacht.
I gotta look up my
Jacob,
yacht size.
Please hit the button.
Damn.
Fuck them kids. And there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. That's a lot. That's just a lot.
I like it.
This is the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast.
Y'all gonna love that button.
To each his own. I'm on the yacht.
100-foot yacht. Yeah, right. I mean, are we invited or
absolutely
that boy ready
even though y'all even though y'all were against yacht. It you still invited.
I know, right, Jacob? I just don't want to fucking
it.
Because whenever you hit the button we the ones that got to kill somebody.
We actually have to go out and do it.
Yeah,
we don't tell you that.
Yeah,
god damn. 100 foot yacht.
See, I don't know who that man is, so I'm not affected by it. But
this is
if I don't press the button,
I am Candyman.
This is Candyman.
When you hit the button, I actually got to go find the person.
He does.
Yeah. I do a lot of research. This is a lot of shit.
It's a
anyway,
lot goes into it.
Nat Boy Radio Podcast. We'll be back.
Let's
on
go,
100
let's go somewhere out with somebody. You know,
we'll go nobody, out on 100 foot.
Nobody's gonna miss them.
For you.
We'll be back.
Shut it down. I got somebody for you.
Damn.
Damn.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Jacob Latimore is killing this shit.
Yeah. Yes.
Damn.
Shit hot.
Yeah. All right, here's where you start looking bad. All you right. ready for it?
Now let's get it.
Now, Jacob Latimore, welcome to the Trap Spelling Bee. Clap it up, goddamn. Yeah. Jacob. Now, before we get started, I want you to
hood education.
Yeah,
that's a part of it. I want you to tell us what city and what school district you're representing for today.
what city and school?
School district you're representing for today. Yeah, you say something. What, you know what? Tell us your tell us your city and your middle school. Middle school.
Milwaukee. Well, by the time I'm
but middle school. We're talking about middle school.
I know, but by the time middle school came, I was homeschooled, so I only went to like elementary school in Milwaukee. So
okay. No, I get it. So yeah. you represent your parents for this?
Sure, why not?
Sure,
sure, why not?
You sure?
Yeah.
All right. You sure?
I think. Mm-hmm. Should I not be?
You should be.
Oh, all right. Only if you don't have faith in your spelling capability.
No, I don't. So let's get it.
You only got five of these. Now, you can request more.
Okay.
But if you get more wrong, it's just going to make you look worse.
I'm about to fuck it up. Come on.
Like, in a good like way or?
No, in a bad way. Come on.
Oh, okay, okay. All right.
Give it up.
Damn. Ooh, shit.
Oh.
Oh, boy. This is...
Is it tough one?
I mean... Jacob Latimore, spell gigolating.
Gigolating. Gigolating.
Gigolating.
I ain't never heard that word before. That's what I
said. You didn't have to. Oh, my bad. You know what? Forgot to tell you that these are the same rules of a natural spelling bee. You can ask for a sentence. You can ask for a place of origin.
Okay. Yeah, you can ask for a sentence.
Oh, you asked for a sentence on this one? She gigolating off them pills.
Oh, okay. I fucked up.
And this is trap. This is trap.
Yeah.
Can I find this word in the dictionary after this?
You can find it in the trap dictionary.
The trap dictionary.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Gigolating.
So gigolating. J-I-G-G? J-I-G?
I can't tell you. You gotta finish the word.
J-I-G-G. No, off. I'm off.
Don't come.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Yeah, she helped me.
What are you doing?
So it's just one G.
Nothing.
It's one G.
Just finish the word.
Finish the
That's
word.
That's all we want.
Jigga lady. Jigga lady. Jigga lady. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
I mean, you gotta do it.
Jigga lady.
Try.
Mm-hmm. Jigga lady. Jigolating. Hold on, I'm about to get it. Hold on, it's coming. I'm warming up. Hold on. J-I-G. Am I warm? Am I correct?
We can't. What the?
Why?
Fuck? What the fuck?
The first three words. The first. I mean, three letters. I mean,
this is literally one word.
Ask for some more help.
Okay. What's it?
Oh, you can ask for a lifeline.
What's the place?
You gotta call.
What's the place of origin?
The place of origin is Louisiana.
Oh my.
Ooh.
Jigolating.
Is that in a song? Is that
you said a song lyric
504
is non-applicable. So no, it hasn't been used in a song.
It haven't been used in a song?
Somebody
how can it be a trap word if it ain't been used in a song?
Using a trap.
It's just using a trap, but ain't using no trap music?
Correct.
How? Sway?
What are you talking about? Niggas say shit all the time.
Right. Jigolating. I have no idea.
Go for it.
You gotta spell it.
J-I-G.
Keep going. Elating.
Elating.
No. Don't do
that. Elating. You know what? You know what, Vanessa?
Jigga.
I was just.
Can't do
I feel
that.
Like you'd be on the side of. You know, go ahead.
J-I-G-A. Jigga. Late. G. A.
Wait, where are you at? Where are you even at in the word?
That's what I'm trying to figure out because you.
Start. Spell the word from top to bottom.
Jigga elating.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, because I heard
some ing at the end.
I really wish you would just spell the whole word from top to bottom.
I just feel like I know what the first two words is and the last three.
Okay, well just spell it. If you got it, just spell it.
I don't know it. I don't want to fuck up, but I don't know it.
You have to fucking do it. Like
jiggle.
You don't want some more. Mm-hmm. Don't do it after that.
I know.
You got five of these at the very least.
And this is the first one.
I'm just fucking. I think jiggle.
Go hard.
I feel like it's two G's, but it's not.
Okay. Amy, look, whatever you feel like, man.
J-I-G-A-L-A-T-I-N-G.
Damn.
Yeah!
Got it.
Damn!
You got it, absolutely.
What the fuck, man?
Yeah, clap, goddamn it.
Jesus.
After all of that.
You know it's hard out here for a pimp.
Don't do that.
And now this jiggling cat motherfucker. And got a whole lot of niggas talking shit. It's hard out here in the trap.
Don't do that like you did a good job.
I did.
That took 20 minutes.
Hey, man.
That took a long time.
As long as I get there. As long as I get there.
Hey,
I fuck with
Jacob Latimore. Spell Thode.
Thode? Thode. Hold up. I've seen this before.
You can ask for whatever you want.
Thode. Okay, can you use it in a sentence?
This drink got me thode.
Easy.
Thode. I feel like I know what it is, but I'm just trying to... I think I'm overthinking. Okay.
You got me thode off with all this shit.
I'm going to tell you the actual origin because it got
to
say.
Okay, what's the origin?
It's only to the card. To the card.
No, it can only say one.
Only
place.
To the card.
What's the origin?
The place of origin is Houston.
Yeah.
Ooh.
You got it. If you don't, come on, man.
T-H. Hold up. Wait. Hold up.
I'm
warming up.
Don't sing. Just don't sing.
Can we throw it up?
What the fuck?
T-H-O. T-H-O.
What? Are you looking at me for confirmation? I'm not gonna. This is not my job. It's for you to get it right. You're representing your school district tonight.
Turned around.
Homeschool.
Homeschool.
Ball, your parents, goddamn it. Here we go.
Thode.
How well did they fare?
Damn. Okay, what's the other options? I ran out.
You got place of origin. Use in a sentence. Use from a song lyric. And
use from a song lyric.
I'm so thode in the game. Southside players screwed up click main.
What song is that?
Hawk throwed in the game.
Throwed in the game.
Easy. T-H-O-D. No, wait. Fuck.
Did you already spell it? Do you want me to?
No, I'm not done. No.
Thode.
When you gotta go. What's your final answer?
I'm thinking about road. And if it's spelled like that with the thode,
this is throat. This is never taking this long.
I just want to get it right.
Me too.
Shout out to Saran.
Thode.
Fuck.
What the fuck? I see. I'm seeing like
he just want to get it right.
I'm seeing like three or four different results in my mind.
That's cool. Hey, the good news is
because it's trap. It can be. You feel me?
The good news is you can take your time.
Yes, you can.
That's what I'm saying. We ain't have no time. I'm like,
that's cool. I got you. I'm just here. My arm is tired. So I'm just drinking one of these.
Thode.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Clap it up, man.
Fuck. Ah,
damn.
Come on, man.
Wait, I said AD. That's ED.
No, you said ED first.
I did.
Yeah, you did.
We'll play it back for you, love.
Oh, shit. Yeah, we'll play it back for you. Jacob Latimore, spell
Shiesty.
Oh, okay. Wait, I know this one. Shiesty, that's my dog.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We heard it too.
Shit. Now I'm overthinking. Mm-hmm. Okay. Shiesty. S H I E S T Y. Oh. E I.
You got it. Nope. Julie. No. Once you did the whole word, it's over. You tried it. It's S H Y S T I E.
Really?
Wow.
I didn't know that. I mean, nobody did. But oh, wow. The people that made this game.
Oh, they made it like shy, like S-H-Y. Okay.
Yeah. I thought it was like nicety.
I mean, you got 2 out of 3.
Right.
You're doing nice-ty. Really good. And nobody's done this good so far.
That's definitely really trap right there.
Nobody's
shy Steve.
Yeah.
Nobody's done this good so far.
Shy's. It says Shy's tie. Shy's tie.
Shy's tie.
That's what they say.
Jacob Latimore! Spell. Die down.
Die down.
Like, die down. I'm an accent.
This one word?
Die down.
It got a dash in the middle?
These are words.
It got a dash in the middle?
You can ask for definition, place of origin, using
a sentence,
using a song, or a lifeline.
Die down.
Definition, place of origin, using a sentence, using a song, or a lifeline.
Lifeline.
You gotta call somebody.
I can't see somebody in the room?
You gotta call somebody.
I gotta call? Oh, no.
You got somebody's phone number in the room?
No.
She at home, ain't she?
Hey, look.
You said she at home.
There's at least one person you can call.
Yeah, one person you can call, right?
There's at least one person you can call.
There you go.
Okay.
Die down. Mm-hmm. I feel like it got some... now I'm thinking about
use it in a sentence.
Now I'm thinking about Shiesty. I'm like, are they going?
You don't know.
You feel me?
Nobody knows. What was that? Three? Is that three or four?
Bro, that's four.
That's four over there.
We're on four.
Okay, go.
Tie down.
Do your thing.
I'm gonna just go with a D I. Ah, God damn it. Die down. Like that. Oh, use it in a sense. My bad.
We gonna go to the mall at the traffic die down.
Ooh.
Ooh.
So that's crazy, right? Okay, so D-I-E. D-I-E-D-O-W-N.
Fuck. Well, what is it?
D-Y.
Fuck them with this D-Y bullshit.
This is weak as hell.
That's bullshit.
Shiesty. That's bullshit.
What trap
is this?
But you know what? I went with it.
You said that when you looked
at that. You did, but that's what I'm supposed to do.
I felt like that, but you and him.
I'm looking at this. I'm like, shy. Maybe
die down. Die down should have been like when.
Ah, so they D-Y.
But I'm saying when something dies down, that means like.
That's what you was going to do. That's why you looked at
it. I never knew it was
spelled like this. It's alleviating traffic, meaning it dies. It no longer exists.
This is not how the trap spread.
You're not changing the color of the traffic.
We can't blame nobody.
That's like changing the color.
This ain't how the trap spread is.
Instead of
D-Y. We not this ignorant.
I don't think you've had. I don't think you've had to.
No, sir.
I'm not 100% sure you've had to spell that word in the recent
years. Never.
So you wouldn't know. So
I still don't believe that.
So
I
God damn.
It should go to the higher.
Jacob like, Latimore.
This look like somebody's name.
Wait, this is the last one.
Dyden.
Dyden, come here.
This is the last one.
Hilarious.
Jacob Latimore.
I'm getting this one.
You really are.
I'm getting this one. Let's go, big baby. Let's go. Let's go.
Nappy Boy Radio believes in you.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Damn, to the people in the back.
Jacob, this is going to be fucking hilarious. Jacob Latimore.
Mm-hmm.
Spell. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe.
Ooh.
Oh, fuck.
Any.
Ooh. That's a. Ooh.
Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Like, any. Ah, shit. I'm going to lose my train of thought.
I'm not even going to say nothing to you on this
one.
Wow. That was one.
Any, meeny.
I feel like I made that up.
You can ask for anything. Any. Hit me with it.
You better ask for everything. You got all the lifelines.
Yeah, let me. Okay, let me use it in. Obviously, use it in a sentence.
Use it in a sentence. Catch a tiger by his tail.
If he kind of
let him go. Any, meeny, miny.
Is this trap though?
Yeah. I mean,
it's urban. I guess.
This is all the games we had to play. Man.
Is this the last one?
If he chooses,
yeah,
so
five. Okay.
This is five.
Shawty is any, meeny, miny.
I can't deal with you right now.
You got to put the lyrics somewhere.
You got to
put the lyrics somewhere.
Eeny, meeny, miny, moe, lover.
Remember that?
Eeny, meeny, miny,
moe. That shit was a jam.
Now you got to spell it, though.
Sure. All right. E. 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 N. N. Ah. E. 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 N. Ah. Okay. E. N. N. Just say the fucking letters, Jake.
You got it, Jake. Come on.
I-E. Any. Is it a dash? Do I gotta say it? Okay. All right, fine. Mm-hmm. Is it a dash?
How would I tell you this?
I don't know. Is that a part of the spelling if I don't say the dashes? Okay. Never
mind. Oh, no. If you don't say the dash, it's part of it, yeah.
Okay, so dash.
Okay, you did. Okay, sure.
Any. Dash.
Wait, go back. Go
wait.
Back. Start up.
Okay. E-N-N-I-E. Dash. Mini. M-I-N-N-I-E. Any, mini, miny. Fuck. Where's the last letter I was on? I-E. M-I-N-N.
You want to start over?
No. I gotta keep it going because it's too long.
No, you gotta give it the whole
okay.
College try.
Okay, E-N-N-I-E dash M-I-N-N-I-E dash.
That boy's shaking.
M.
fuck was money?
M-I-N. Why? Yeah. I'm going to just go ahead. M-I-N-Y dash M-O-E.
That's it.
That was a long way around.
That was wrong as fuck. God damn. That was wrong as a motherfucker.
Were there two N's or was it just the E-N?
Holy shit, that was wrong. God damn, you got wrong in the first three letters. That was E-N-E-Y. Crazy. That was a long fucking word to get wrong for that long. That was crazy.
That don't look like.
I will tell you this. This is five. I got.
This is the trap.
I got five more.
All right, I'm hanging up my jersey.
Hanging it up. You actually did a good job. Right, everybody clap good. It up, goddammit.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, if you need help with the trap.
A lot of people don't.
If you ever need a tutor, hit my line.
Give me your phone number.
You know what I'm saying? If you at least want a C.
No, we're not.
C+.
Yep. Holla at me. Nope, hit the button. We'll be.
You know what I'm saying? If you want to pass,
nah, we're not.
Upper D area?
Nah, hit the button.
Upper D area?
Hit the button.
Shut it down.
Oh my God. We will be right back. Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. What is wrong with this nigga? The fuck? Guys, go pre-order my new book. Look at this shit. You know what I had to fight for in this fucking book? And I'm so glad that I held my ground on this. Because it was just going to be a normal joint. See how that looks? Now, what you can't tell is that all the pages are black with gold writing. Look at that. I'm so glad I held my foot on this. Look at that. Oh, all the pages are black.
It's gorgeous.
I put my book in dark mode for y'all. You see what I did? Now, if that don't deserve a pre-order, I put my book in dark mode. For everybody. If y'all could just go pre-order this, make this a bestseller, man. I want to have a bestseller. And it's not something that you necessarily have to read. I gave two of these to my kids today, and my daughter was like, I don't drink, but I'll take one. I know you don't drink. What the fuck are you talking about? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. I am your homeboy, Tpain, a.k.a. your girlfriend's boyfriend.
And I am Vanessa Fraction, a.k.a. Action Fraction, the main attraction, your partner's distraction.
And I am Pip, a.k.a. Mr. Fresh Prince, Mr.
God damn!
And I'm the only one, Jacob Latimore, actor, singer, a.k.a. Emmett off the shy. You dig? Let's go. And this is Nappy Boy Radio. Live with the boy Tpain.
Yeah.
Right? You figured it out.
Good job.
So, Jacob, what we're going to do here, this is your creative curse word of the week. Clap it the fuck up.
Creative curse word. Ah.
This creative curse word of the week. Now, what you're going to do is you're going to take this book. You're going to open it up. Now, it has two sides. You're going to flip to a random page on this side, and you're going to flip to a random page on this side. And then after that, you're going to have to give us a motherfucking story. That includes that word. You
okay,
ready?
All right, for sure.
So here we go. One page.
What the fuck?
Okay.
Dude, where was
it? One page?
That's one page. And then
one
the second
page.
The other page.
The other side.
Other side. Mm-hmm.
You said what the fuck?
Flip it. You got it.
Flip it.
Random.
Stop where you want to.
That's it.
Well, come on.
That's your mother.
Wow.
That's your mother. Ladies and gentlemen, Jacob Lattimore's creative curse word of the week. It's twat beater.
Yeah.
Oh.
I would love to hear this story.
I would love to hear a story that includes twat beater. You ready for it?
Wait, what does twat mean again?
You better figure it out.
You better know. I can't wait till it's included in your story because you're gonna have to figure this out.
Fucking. It sounds more like an insult than just like
you okay?
It's not an insult.
I don't see it.
It's a tweet.
It's not an insult.
Beat my twat. I ain't.
See what I'm saying? I told you. Okay. I told you. I knew she was tweaking.
So twat. If you grew up in the 90s, that's a vagina. Wow. Mm. Now, beater on the other
side. Now,
it depends on what side of society you want to be on
exactly.
tonight at this point.
Oh,
wow.
So,
I would love to hear a story that includes this at the end. Here we go. You ready?
I don't know what the hell I'm about to say.
You got a story. Here we go. Talk to us about it.
I was in church.
Yeah.
Ooh.
I was walking in the church.
This is already crazy.
My grandfather said, son, I'm going to put you on a suit, and I'm going to take you to church
okay.
on Sunday.
All right.
I said, okay. But I don't know where I'm going with this.
Keep going.
No, you okay.
I got my suit on. I'm fly. It's ready. We walk in and praise and worship. The band is going crazy.
As bands do.
As bands go crazy.
Absolutely.
The choir is going silly. Singing.
They also do that. Okay.
I'm scooting into the aisle. Mm-hmm. You know, you just do a little scoot mm-hmm. like that. Mm-hmm. I find my seat. Mm-hmm. Preacher's preaching. He pulls up songs. Start breaking down the scriptures.
What do you say?
I was asleep. You know.
You know,
the church service was just too long.
Yeah.
It's too long.
I mean, lost my attention.
Uh-huh. And then I woke up to the word.
Ooh.
Twat beater.
Yeah!
And I was like, what? That got my attention.
And then what he said.
And he said, amen. That is tonight's service. I see y'all next.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. I appreciate you motherfuckers coming through, clapping.
Oh, yeah.
Jacob Latimore killed this motherfucker. I appreciate y'all coming through. You feeling good?
I'm always
good. You feeling good? You feeling good?
I'm feeling good.
You are all black.
I gotta get home to my man's twat beater.
Oh, damn. We finally figured it out. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank y'all for coming through. This is the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Hey. We'll see you next week if we still got a contract.